Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we are going to see how to move the mouse pointer after a particular duration of a time by using a small PowerShell script. Actually at first I didn't thought of sharing this video, but later I thought it would be beneficial for the other people who are looking for this kind of functionality on internet. Actually, I was looking for this kind of code snippet for my DIY project. Actually, I found this piece of code snippet on GitHub, one of the GitHub repository. So I would leave this piece of small code snippet in my description, so you can use it whoever needs it, and also you can modify it depending upon your requirement. So let's understand a little bit of about this script. So this is an PowerShell IDE which is inbuilt in most of the Windows operating system. So this is its editor window, this is its output window, this is number of commands which you want to use. When you click any of the command here, it will also displays its description, and if you are connected to the internet, it will give a lot more set of information here regarding that command. So we are not going to dig in deep with each of these every commands, just we are going to understand what this script exactly is and what it exactly does. So at the line 1 we have cleared the host, then we have displayed a message such as moving message. So you will see this kind of message when you start this, when you run this script. Then we have imported a namespace which is nothing but Windows system.windows.form. Then we initialized a variable with the value 50. So this value 50 is nothing but the number of pixel count from where your mouse cursor should move from its initial position. Okay, so currently I have set this value as 50, so you can also modify it depending upon your requirement. So we have applied a while loop. In the while loop, we have initialized the three variables, that is P, X and Y. So in the P variable, we have created used the position property of this method, of this object, cursor object. And in the X and Y variable, we are storing the current, we are storing this value, that is pixel value. Means if your pixel value, current pixel value is 10, means x 10 plus 50 means it will move 50 pixels from its original position. Similarly, we have also stored the pixel count in y direction also. Then we have passed this x and y values, means coordinates, to this point method, and then the value of this point method we have assigned it to cursor position property. After that, what we have did is we have started a timer for 10 seconds. So you can also vary the time here, and later we have configured the plus or minus variable to -1, so that after this number of seconds, it will also move the cursor of the mouse to its original position. So I will run the script and show you how it works. So the basic use of this script is when you use Citrix receiver, your Citrix receiver will log off if there is no any activity for particular duration of time. So if you want your Citrix receiver to be logged in, even if you are not using your PC, you can use these kinds of script. I am saying as these kinds of script, but not exactly like this. But you can, you may have got an idea about how to move the, how to create an activity by moving a mouse pointer with this script. And also the second use of this script is while using the Skype for Business. So if there is no any activity on your computer, or status in the Skype becomes as inactive, so you may create these kinds of script and keep it running in the background, so the mouse moves after a particular duration of the time, and the status will always be active. And similarly, if you have connected to any of the RDP connections, the connection will also will not get closed after a particular duration of idle time. Okay. So currently, I will run this script by selecting this and run selection. Okay. So the script is running now. Now you can check the original position of the cursor mouse, and after 10 seconds the cursor will move above, and after 10 seconds again it will move back to its original position. So if you are not able to see the cursor properly, I will move it in the at the center. Now you can check the exact change in the position. So we can implement these kind of functionalities to keep your computer or any of the softwares active. So it is not necessary each and every time to copy paste this PowerShell script into this PowerShell window and then manually run it. What we can do is we can save this script onto the desktop by giving any of the file name to it. For C, untitled one. Okay, I'm giving this file name as it is, keeping this file name as it is. Click on save. Okay, it is telling me that I don't have permission to save the script in C Windows. Okay, we will try it in other drive. Let's see whether it gets successfully saved. Okay, it is currently successfully saved. So next I will search that script. Okay, the script has been saved in drive G with untitled one. So what you can do is, instead of opening the PowerShell window each and every time, I have created another PowerShell script with the same code and I have kept it on my desktop. You can right click it, run with PowerShell. So you can execution policy change. So what you can select is, you can press A, yes for all option. So currently your script is running now. You can see the position of the cursor getting changed after 10 seconds. So just now it has moved. You can also keep this window minimized when you have kept your PC idle, so that any of the software application will not get logged up due to without any activity going on to the screen. So I think this small script has helped you in solving some of the problems. I hope this video has helped. So if you like this video, please like, share and comment. Thank you for watching this.